Hi, I'm Scott Cantley, Vice President of Livingston Rugby Club. I'm here to give a quick match report from the weekend. We went over to Kirkcaldy and we came back with a victory, with a bonus point victory, winning 34-25. First half started well, got a penalty converted by Craig Bowling. First couple of minutes, it was 3-0 up, closely followed by a try by Ross Neal. Conversion was unfortunately missed, so it gave us an 8-0 lead. Around about this time, they converted a penalty of their own to make it 8-3. And really from there, we were on the back foot for a bit with Stevie Logan in the sin bin for 10 minutes. But the defence stood up well with 14 men. We didn't concede a score to them at all in that time. And in fact, Andy McMahon intercepted just inside his own half, ran under the post to score a try. Give us a lead of 15-3 at that time. First half, the forwards, as much as we were a smaller pack compared to Kirkcaldy, they fronted up well. The scrummaging area was sort of identified as possibly being a problem beforehand, but apart from losing the first scrum, the guys dominated, in my opinion, against the bigger pack. Obviously, technique from the smaller guys won out at the end of the day. Towards the end of the first half, unfortunately, Alistair Laird got sin-binned himself. So with a couple of minutes before half-time, their winger ran in a good score to bring them back in the game. So at half-time it was 15-8 to Livingston. And obviously for the second half we were starting with 14 men, which was always going to be a bit of a battle.
So is discipline quite a thing for the team, is it?
Just a little silly things, I suppose. Alistair Laird getting sin-binned for not being 10 metres back in a penalty, which was quite harsh in a way, with the guy just running directly at him. I suppose in a way he didn't give a referee any option but to sin-bin him. Stevie Logan, I think that was possibly just one of a team penalty, as we call them. The penalty's been racking up against the team, and unfortunately the referee has got to say to the captain, right, the next one's going to be off, and fortunately for Stevie, he was the man to take the sin bin.
Okay, so coming out of the second half, you were a man down. What was the sort of plan then?
Really to get through the remainder of that sin bin. If we could go through without conceding any points as we did when Stevie Logan was in the sin bin, the guys, again, defensively, we've been very good from this game and the last game against Murrayfield. There's not been many missed tackles. The guys have really stood up well, given the gaps that have been between fixtures. I know a lot of the guys have been running out of the second team to keep up match fitness and keep on top of their game. And for a few of the older guys, it's let the body recover between games as well. So we've come out well, I think, despite the last game, or the month between games, really, from Christmas till the game against Murrayfield, and then obviously the game at the weekend there, away to Kirkcaldy. We've shown up very well.
And do you have a man in the match for the game against Kirkcaldy?
It's hard to pinpoint an individual. There was a few guys that really put their hand up. I mean, I suppose biased in a way, being an ex-front rower, I would like to give it to all four props and the hooker that stood up well in that scrummaging. I thought Aaron Johnston, again, stood up very well for the team and led from the front. And certainly in the backs, the centres did very well again. Ross Neal and Andy McMahon communicated well with the rest of the guys. So if I'm pushed for a man match, I would say Aaron Johnston, our captain, he certainly led from the front.
So how are the team sitting in the league just now?
We're sitting fourth place at the moment. We're where we want to be, really. We've got that 6-point cushion now. We play Jed Forest on the 1st of March at home, which will be a very, very big game for us. Certainly I'm looking forward to the game. It'll be totally different from what it was down there. We know they're top of the league. They've only lost one game so far this season. I would love it if we were the second team to beat them this season.
And have we got a game on Saturday?
There's no game for the first team on Saturday due to the internationals and the cup fixtures. Really it's a free weekend for anybody not involved in the cup or rescheduled fixtures. There is a fixture for the second team. They're playing against Selkirk, third team, on Saturday, which is a 1:30 kickoff, and then obviously we've got the Scotland-England game kicking off at 5 o'clock. So if you're not going to the game, then come along to a club and watch it on the big screen in the club.